the government is again examining a proposal to tax the blockchain ecosystem, which includes cryptocurrencies and NFTs. In fact, the tax department wants the framework for taxing the use of blockchain for commercial purposes to be implemented even before legislation on cryptocurrencies is brought in, as it finalizes legislation that is to be introduced in the upcoming winter session of Parliament. The government is reportedly considering a middle path on cryptocurrencies. A government official who did not wish to be named told Business Standard that even when they are not regulated, the use of virtual currencies and NFTs is prevalent, and this is leading to a loss of revenue for the government. However, the official clarified that taxing such assets would not mean that trading in them would be legitimized. Instead, it would only be a step to tax such transactions which are currently slipping past the tax net. A similar plan to tax cryptocurrencies was considered in 2018. The official said that the framework for taxing blockchain would stay even if the government decides to ban assets such as cryptocurrencies, because blockchain can be used in many areas. With that in mind, a framework for taxing the use of blockchain in other areas and sectors is likely to be drawn up. So, what exactly are the details of the proposal under consideration?
With wider adoption of NFTs and cryptocurrencies, the tax authorities have moved a proposal to impose goods and services tax on virtual currencies as well as NFTs. The proposal is being examined by the Finance Ministry, as the tax authorities believe that these transactions, the transactions on virtual currencies and NFTs, are outside the tax net and should be brought under the tax net to plug revenue loss or leakages. So the tax authorities are now considering to impose GST on virtual currency trade as well as NFTs. And the proposal is to consider transfer, storage, supply, exchange, management, trade, and even creation of cryptocurrencies as services under the goods and services tax regime. So now, if you trade in cryptocurrencies through an exchange, the exchange will have to pay GST to the government, and the exchange might pass on that tax liability on customers, and you and I, if we trade in cryptocurrencies, will have to pay that GST, which could be about 18%, since services are classified, services under the GST regime are currently taxed at 18%. And a similar proposal was considered in 2018 as well, when cryptocurrency trade had started flourishing. And now the tax authorities believe that, again, since cryptocurrency trade has started picking up, the investments are about 6 trillion rupees, and as well as NFT is being endorsed by so many celebrities, now is the time to impose this tax and bring these transactions under the tax net.
According to the proposal, the exchanges may have to pay GST, and they may pass on the implication of the tax to customers. This would mean individuals having to pay GST on the transaction value of the trade executed. Some Indian crypto exchanges already pay GST on the trading fees they collect from users for facilitating trades. According to broker discovery and comparison platform BrokerChooser, India has the highest number of crypto owners in the world at 10.07 crore. And India's cryptocurrency market reportedly grew 641% over the past year. The push also comes against the backdrop of the endorsement of NFTs by Bollywood actors such as Amitabh Bachchan and Salman Khan.
If you like this video, share it and subscribe to Business Standard. For more news, views and insights, log on to www.business-standard.com. Do also follow us on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Telegram and LinkedIn.